Welcome to Show and Tell with the Two Mortgage Guys. We come to you live every Tuesday on Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, and Twitter. Today, we are going to be speaking with Leanne Fogg from Habitat of Humanity from Kokomo. Stick around. Joining us today is Leanne Fogg, Executive Director for Kokomo's Habitat for Humanity affiliate. Leanne lives in Kokomo with her husband of 17 years and their two teenage sons. She graduated from Maconaquah High School before going on to earn her degree from Ivy Tech in Kokomo. In addition to the work she does for Kokomo's Habitat, Leanne mentors for Bridges Outreach, volunteers for her church, is a booster club representative at her son's school, and serves on the executive board for another local nonprofit. She's driven to support her community in any way she can and has a heart for giving. In Leanne's downtime, she enjoys reading, camping, traveling with her friends and family. Leanne, thanks for your community service and thanks for joining us on our show today.
Hey, yeah. Thanks for having me.
Hey, that's good. We have Bridges too. We got like some special places in our hearts for Bridges. So thanks for helping them out too.
Yes, I've mentored for I think 7 years now, and I really enjoy the relationship and bond that I get with the students.
Good. That's awesome. That's awesome. Well, look, we want to bring some awareness to Habitat for Humanity in Kokomo, and just, you know, anyone watching is not really familiar with what it is you guys do and how you're helping people. We just want to kind of cover all that. So I guess our opening question is, give us kind of an overview of what Habitat does and what you guys are about.
Okay, so Habitat has been here since 1988, so we've been here for 34 years in Howard County. I know everybody knows the national brand that's been around, but in our community, it's been 34 years. We just finished up our 66th house that was on Diamond Street. So we just finished that up and got somebody moved in. We're working on their mortgage right now. What we do is provide housing for those that would not be able to qualify for a traditional loan. So we use an affordable mortgage calculator, and Habitat builds the house, pays for it up front, and then we do a mortgage that's 0% interest, and they have a mortgage that's based solely on their financials, what they can afford.
And then how long is the term on that? It's not 30 years, is it?
It depends on their income. It depends on where we have, if they are higher in the tier of the, so we do off of AMI of the, you know, area median income. And if they're in the higher part of that, because we go from 30 to 60%, then we could do a shorter term. But if they fall in the lower percentage, it may be close to 30.
There you go. So see, that's great. So it's, that's like really the definition of affordable housing, right? When we're trying to help people out, as you guys are like looking at the income levels, which is really what makes that affordable for some of those people.
Yeah. So we only will do 25% of their income. So it's based off, obviously, their income, how many they have in the household. And then we just make sure, including their utilities and insurance and phones and stuff like that, that they have a mortgage that they can afford.
So how many homes a year are you building on average? And then in addition to that, like what, how are you determining who you're helping?
So we are a small affiliate. You have some that are very large. I'm a part-time executive director, and then we have a part-time media person, but we're the only two employees. So we're a very, very small affiliate. We only typically build one house a year. Okay. So we are 100% volunteer basis on our build. So our builds usually run every Saturday during the build. Like I said, open to the community. Anybody can come out and help. Sometimes we partner with organizations, and then they'll do like a team building day, and their staff will come out and we'll do that during the week. But typically we don't do builds during the week. So with only building a house on a Saturday, it definitely takes a while. It's not so anywhere between 9 to 12 months it takes to build one house.
Oh, wow. So I didn't realize you spent that much time on one property. So, I know Steve and I both volunteered in the past. So I guess in my mind, we were there for a day and there was 1,000 people working, right? I assume you did it in like 48 hours.
We did one of those, like you were talking about, Leanne, where it was with the Realtor Association. So during the week, They had it blocked out with times where people could go and help out, like you said, and the weekend as well. But yeah, we were able to volunteer during the week and got a lot more of it done in a short amount of time.
Yeah, we love those partnerships that we can build with organizations. We had several this year. One business brought 40 people, which was awesome. You know, sometimes you don't get that many. Sometimes it's just a few. And then sometimes Saturdays, because they don't really have to RSVP on a Saturday. You just kind of show up, wear closed-toed shoes, and sign a waiver. And then we put you to work. So some Saturdays we get lots of volunteers, and then some Saturdays it's just more of our committee.
Well, I apologize if you said it earlier, but did you how do you determine who who's getting the home?
Okay, so we run a selection process. We hold what's called an information meeting. Those will run typically in the fall, 6 months or so before the build would start. An information meeting, people will attend and they will get to know everything they want to know about Habitat, how it works, the sweat equity hours that they have to put in. We consider this program a hand up, not a hand out. They have to put a lot of sweat and tears into helping us build this and build their home. So they learn everything that's required, what the minimum maximum income level is, all that stuff. They have opportunity to ask questions. At that point, if they would like to continue, then they would get an application. So from the application, it obviously does their like tax stuff. We collect all that information. We run them through a sex registry, things to those sort. And if they pass all those, then they go to an in-home visit. So once they go to the in-home visit, we actually want to make sure there's a need there, a need for stable housing. And then the selection committee will present it anonymously. We leave out sex, gender, race, things to those, and they present it to the board. Let's say we have five families that make it through the process. They present those to the board, like I said, anonymously. And then from the need and the criteria that's presented, the board will pick a family for the next build.
Wow.
That's neat though. So on that, what's typical like that? Do we have like a list of people, families that are constantly wanting to try to see if they can get in for a Habitat build?
Yeah, we don't take a list. It's a lot to keep up on. So we'll post it on our website and then on our social media platforms when we hold the information meeting. We usually have a couple dates, you know, to try to be flexible for people to attend. So typically we'll have a lot of people, maybe 30 families show up for the information meeting. Only about half of them will turn in applications, you know, and it kind of like dwindles down to, so there's typically about five usually that'll qualify by the time it's ended. So we do get a lot of people call for that information. But until the board decides when we start a new process or a new information meeting, they'll just have to start there and attend that first.
Give us an idea of some of the specific job description. Like if you wanted to volunteer as an individual, or if you wanted to gather up your office and come down for a Saturday, like what are some of the things that the volunteers are actually physically doing on the job site?
I mean, we build the house from the ground up. So you name it, we pretty much could use it at some point, whether it be roofing, electricity, plumbing, anything to that sort. There's a lot of times businesses, like I said, just do the work day that I talk about. There's times that people will provide lunch. We try to provide lunch to all of our volunteers on Saturdays. It's an 8-hour day. So instead of people having to leave to go get lunch, we try to get volunteers or support to provide lunch for our volunteers. So some organizations will provide the lunch. If they don't want to come out and do the labor, they will pick up a lunch day and either have pizzas delivered. We've had some people, like a small group from a church, they made sandwiches and soups and then brought it out to the site. So they can always pick to do that as well.
Which is awesome, right? Because not everybody is a handy person where they can jump in and do stuff. But We like Ryan said, we've helped on different projects before, but I can remember one we jumped in for a rotary, and it was just we're at the point where it needed painted inside. So it was some of the painting. So, you know, most everybody can paint the brush a little bit. So,
yeah, I mean, believe me, I don't have construction background either, but my previous employer, we were involved with Habitat, and none of us had construction, but we went out and we actually accomplished. We have a committee that's there and they have the knowledge, so they guide you. You don't have to come with skills by any means. We just ask closed toe shoes, but if we need hammers, we have hammers, we have tool belts, we have hard hats. If hard hats are required for the project for the day, we provide all that stuff, so you don't even have to bring your own tools or anything.
So you've got to have like, I don't know what the position would be, like a team leader, somebody who's there every weekend who knows what they're doing, right? I mean, are these people on payroll or are they volunteering?
Nope. They are volunteer. It's actually quite amazing. It blows me away that some of these our construction committee volunteers have been doing this for years. And they give up pretty much every Saturday, you know, and they lead this and they have a passion for it. And it's just amazing. Wow. But yes, they have the skills and they know. So Chuck Schaefer is our project lead and he does the building. I think he's been here probably 15 years.
Yeah. Wow, and they had like, incredible. You guys had a great one. It was with Greg Hoppus.
Yeah, I remember. Yes. Hoppus.
It used to be with Habitat for a long time. It was that same thing that almost any Saturday you could go by a Habitat house and Greg would be there with his truck. So.
Yes, he was. We lost him last year.
Yeah. Good guy. So. Hey, is there an age limit? Can like a church youth group bring out some teenagers and help, or?
For OSHA and the requirements, at least the age of 16 to be on the build site. We're working on getting relationship with our schools and building the trades up that way. And then at the school level, their insurance would cover. So any age, you know, whatever class or program that they had that would want to come out can do that. We actually had one of our schools, the National Junior Honor Society, came out and did a volunteer day. Yeah. So in that, there is no requirement. But just to show up on a Saturday to build on the site, you have to be 16. But if a youth group would want to provide lunch or do something to that sort and come out and be a part of it, there is no age limit to that.
So I keep picturing like the extreme home makeover, you know, it's like move that bus, right? And there's the big reveal. Now with your program, I mean, the future homeowners, their hands on. So they're probably not going to be too many surprises by the time it's done. But do you have a reveal day or is there a final day where it's like we're finished and what's that?
Yes,
like?
We are getting ready to have that. We haven't set the date yet. The homeowner picks the date. It's called a home dedication day. So we let them get in, get all their stuff situated, things to that sort, and we will have a home dedication where we will invite the organizations and volunteers and stuff that have opened, like that have volunteered on the house, and where they can come and look through it. Because a lot of them, they were painting or putting the frame up and they haven't seen it finished. So we will open up to that and we dedicate and bless the house and dedicate it to the family.
Wow. That's awesome. So, good stuff. It's all community stuff.
I want to know, and I know you've been with them for 2 years now, but and I understand the concept of helping somebody into home ownership. I mean, it's a foundational part of their life.
Yes.
It sets the tone and confidence to go out and achieve so many other things, right?
Mm-hmm.
You have any past success stories as far as like a difference it's made in someone's life, like things you've seen them go on to do afterwards?
No, I can't say that necessarily go on and do afterwards, but the one that pulled them on, when I first started here and I met with one of the partner families, they had come in to pay their mortgage and stuff. And we got to talking and he's a single gentleman, older, has had a rough upbringing, was homeless at one point in his life. And he looked at me and said, I never thought in my whole life I'd ever own my own home. And now I do. And then I looked at him, I said, and that's why I'm here. That's why I came to work for Habitat. Yeah. You know, moments like that. He never thought he'd ever have his own home. And now he's a homeowner. So just the pride that he takes, he's very, very grateful, you know, and doesn't take it for granted. And you can see it thrive in other areas of his life. Basically, you don't have to worry about his home. Like, he has a good home.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. And that's like, and if it wasn't for the volunteers and the staff and Habitat for itself on how they do this and structure it and do the loan at no interest, it would be impossible for him maybe to get a regular traditional loan.
Correct. So. And that's usually, that's where we go to, is people that can't tradition. Most of our mortgages with escrow run between $350 and $400 a month.
Wow.
Yeah, it's, you can't, you pretty much can't finance anything. Maybe a car, maybe.
Yeah. And not even that. Sometimes those are even higher than that that we're seeing.
So. Yeah, true. So, it, I mean, it is an awesome thing that they do. Like I said, it's interest free and we make it so they can afford. And I was a part of it in my previous job, but actually to be in and see it firsthand or whatever, it's really amazing what they do. So I'm trying to get us more involved in the community and do things like this and bring more awareness to what Habitat is doing.
Right. Yeah. And that's what, yeah, it is, right? Because it's got such a need on it. And so like one of them I saw that Carrie had that scrolled down through there was like, you know, getting the newsletter, but it's also like trying to figure out a way to have somebody, if they decide to say, hey, let's volunteer, or even just take, like you said, doesn't have to be a whole group. It can just be like four or five people from an office to go out on a Saturday.
Yes.
They could just do it. Should they just contact you guys up front to figure out where the build's at, or where can, is there a spot they can go to find that out?
We will keep the address updated on habitatkokomo.com. So at the bottom, it'll tell the location of the build. We just finished one, so we don't have a current location right now. We won't start one. Hopefully in the spring we'll start. Those things are still up in the air. But when we have our next location for our build site, we will post it. So anybody can go at any time, see where the build is. And like I said, and every Saturday we're building.
Yeah. It's just so cool, I think, with how you're talking about trying to get the trades back in for the school. Because they're starting to do some of that. Because back, you know, in the 70s, 80s, 90s, they had building trades and it sort of fell apart. And it's starting to come back in a little bit where we need that skill set on the job site. So I know, like, even at the state level for the Builders Association, they've got projects they're trying to work with some of the high schools and community colleges to try to get that back in there so they can get some of that skill set. So this would be an ideal place to join that together right in your community.
Yeah. We haven't had it established yet. Like I said, we're so small and working part-time. It's hard, but that's our goal. We're hoping to grow this and we can build more houses a year. I know there's some of the larger affiliates, they can build 20 houses in a year. We can only dream we can help that many people, but you know, as long as we're helping one family at a time, hopefully we can build it in the next coming year, we can add more houses.
Good stuff. Good. Ryan, you got anything you can think of? We didn't hit on it.
I think we covered a lot. We appreciate you coming on the show, taking some time out of your day.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
It's always awesome to learn about things going on in our community that people can get involved in and make a difference. So thanks for sharing.
All right, thank you.
We appreciate it. Thanks, Leanne.
Thanks.
All right, graphs and charts, oh my. Next week, we'll be sharing some amazing historical charts to show where we've been and where we're heading in 2023. If you have any interest in the economy, real estate, mortgage rates, and your retirement account, mark your calendars. You're not going to want to miss this.